Hi everybody, Cappy here, and I've got my gouache out today, and I'm just going to share, just doing a little landscape type thing, and I'm just going to put some fresh paint out. So yeah, this is all student grade, so not professional grade at all. It is made by Royal Talents, and it is their art creation gouache, and this is ultramarine blue, their ultramarine blue, a little bit lighter than, oh sorry, that's cobalt blue, my mistake. I do have that, yeah, yes, here we go. Their blue is a little bit different to the one that we use. It looks like I'm missing a paint. Anyway, that is what we're going to be using today. There is some titanium white that I'm putting out. Limited palette. Again, not much yellow ochre left. Yellow ochre. I'll have to go and grab some more of these sometime. And then I'm using deep rose or magenta as my red. They don't have alizarin crimson. So those are my colours. They call it cobalt blue, they say ultramarine, not exactly the same, not a problem. I also have scarlet, which can be used, but I prefer the crimson. And so let's have a look at what we can do, and it's going to have to probably be a quick one because this camera is pretty full. So I've got two things of water. One is to clean, one is to wet. And so what we do with gouache, we're going to start with a light. Let me just clean these out quickly. Quick sketch, small brush. Let me check, where's my small brush? Yeah, small brush, quick sketch on here, as in the method we teach here at Studio 7. Get some of that in there. Blue. Touch of yellow ochre into it. Nice and dark. And now watery. And to do my sketch. So it's going to start at the back, and I'm going to base it on the one project that is available on the 5-day channel challenge. It's the Mary River. So there is a embankment that comes out here. There is one that runs that way, and then over here it becomes much more a tad higher here. And I'm going to bring that through to that position there, keep the river wide, and then we've got another embankment that goes out the back here, and we have trees, a nice bunch of trees here. So I'm just going to, and remember this is the sketch stage, so part one of the Moore method of painting. So we're just getting that quick, this is the drawing stage, get that drawing in. Okay, there we go. And then out back we're going to bring through, I'm going to bring my horizon line through at about that point. It's probably just under halfway. Let's check that quickly. Yeah, just a little bit under halfway. And then we've got some little mountain range running through the back here. Just loosely based on the project, the Mary River. And I'm going to do something a little bit different with it. Okay. So, and then I'm going to put a row of trees in the distance here. Bring those trees in, and then this is a field between here and there. So I just got to see that we still got time on this thing here, seems to be. So I'm going to put in a stock tree right here. Some trees there. Okay, now that concludes step one, which is the drawing stage. I'll just make sure that I'm online here, all lined up. Okay, now I'm going to go to my bigger brush and just get some water onto that, and now we're going to start with blocking in. And I'm going to work on the darkest colors first, and I'm going to just get a green as well while I'm at it. Mix up a nice dark green. I'm going to leave some of that dark purple sticking through, a bit here and there, and get this green down. So this is the blocking in stage, and get some nice shapes onto these trees coming out here. There we go. And then let's do this one. A slightly lighter value there. And then the ones right at the back are going to be even lighter in value. pop those in. Okay. Next thing I want to work on are the mountains. Okay. So next up are the values on the mountains, and I'm going to touch bluer, grayer with this. Leave some of that purple in there. Let that dry up. Quite a big piece of tissue paper for that. Okay, so now I want to work on my field, and I'm going to start at the back. And what I've done is I've taken yellow ochre and white, and I'm going to just pull that in. I just need a touch more water because this is the first layer. That distant color, and I've actually pulled in some green into this now from that side, which has helped with the aerial perspective in an unexpected way by just darkening that up a bit. So just work this in. As we come closer, the color is going to get yellower, and more red will come into the tone. In other words, it's going to become warmer as we come to the front, the forward section of this piece of or this drawing, sketch, study, whatever you want to call it. Right. I'm working on watercolor paper. This is 300 gram watercolor paper, and it's got a nice rough side to it. Both sides are rough, and I'm quite happy with the way that's turned out now. Obviously, we're going to put in details. I might just strengthen up this front area a bit, just add a touch more color into that. And now I'm going to come onto this embankment here. Okay, that is a diagonal embankment, so I'm not going to worry too much about that at the moment. So I'm going to use my yellow ochre and then to add it. You've got to be very careful with this because this scarlet or magenta is quite strong. So I'm going to use that. Sorry about the screaming in the background. Those are kiddies playing at the park, at their apartment block. They're having a great time. It does tend to get pesky if you're trying to take a nap. But anyway, a Sunday afternoon nap, but doesn't quite work out. Anyway, that's besides the point. I don't need one. I had a good rest. So, here we go. Okay. And then I'm going to lighten this off as we go further back. Get some of that in the mix. What I've done is I've added white to the yellow. Okay, in the front I added red to the mix, the scarlet, so that we've got that differentiation between the distant section. As if we use the same color, it's going to look like it's standing up. I'm going to go a bit more red in the front here. Nicely blended. Gouache gives you the best of both worlds in terms of acrylic and watercolor. The advantage of gouache is that you can work back into it once the layer becomes wet, but you do need to work carefully. The first layer goes on thin, and with water. The next layer after that, you put on a nice bit without a lot of water. So, right, we're going to work on this embankment here. So let's get some of this. Quite like this tone. Just work that in for the time being. This being very much the as I said, the blocking in stage. So that much lighter here again. Just to separate those two. Okay, part two, back again, and I have blocked in the river, and after having to delete stuff off my phone, I may have to do it one more time. Right, so we've established redder towards the front, lighter or cooler towards the back. Now I want to put in some sky, so I'm going to go with a bigger brush. Bigger brush, and where's my tissue paper? Tissue paper here. And for this, I'm going to turn this one around, and I'm going to need to get some water there. it's just been a study. I'm not going to be too particular about the way my sky looks, but as we get closer to the horizon, it is going to get lighter. So we just work this in up to those mountains, and then we'll use some white to lighten it back, possibly add in some clouds. Just get some water on this brush again. So have to work carefully around this previous wash that's down, because it can reactivate with water. It'll be darker up near the top here. This would be the sky that is closest to you. Right, now we can turn it around and clean that brush off and use just some water on here. It will look a lot better once it's dried off. Just clean that brush off. It looks quite moody at the moment, so I work in some clouds around that area. Okay, so that's just a quick one on establishing the values with your blocking stage. And I'm going to work on highlights. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in another colour, which is my two extra colours. I have a light yellow, and this one is a lemon yellow, which is known as primary. And I think I'll use that one for this part of things. Work on some highlights from my tree. Don't want to take all of the darker color away. This is more middle tone. Be a mid-tone value this. Some yellow to it. Let this dry a bit more. So I'm actually dry brushing this and not using a lot of water at all at this stage. This is basically the two. The blue and that yellow being mixed together. And And yeah, that's it. Just that blue and that yellow. I think I'll leave that for now. Let it get dry. I'm going to go across to this other tree. That one. I think I need to put a few more in the background. So I need my smaller brush. Go back to that. Get some water. I'm going to go back to this other color and just shoot up the back area a bit. Add in a few more points of interest. Couple of small bushes here and there. That sense of depth. I'm not going to play around too much with that anymore. I've gotten to mountains again. Glasses off for this one. Just add in some shading, a shadow into a couple of these areas on the mountain. That's working. And then in the front, I need something this tree. Add some lighter touches in here. to a touch of grass on the bank. Happy with that one. Work on this bank a bit. Strokes I'm bringing at an angle towards the water to create that sense of an embankment. You want to keep everything, if that's my horizon line there. We need to, I'm just going to make sure we're on camera here. There's my horizon line. It's running there. This embankment is going to stray pretty much in line with that and basically with the mountains. All that's happening is at a point the mountains are moving down. The same here with the embankment. It stays almost on that line there, but it does have a bit of a dip here and then obviously down there. It's basically sticking to that line. Then you take it and you turn it ever so slightly to bring it forward. At this point the river is wider than it will be in the distance. The same with detail, less obvious in the back, more obvious in the front. Okay, so now I want to bring up this color a bit here. Some white into this. It'll strengthen this embankment area up nicely. To darken this side here. So we're going to mix up an orange, add a touch of blue, and that's going to give us a nice little brown. And that we can blend into the mix here. Just get some water onto this just to help it along a bit, and there we go. That strengthens up that bank a bit. I think I want to bring this, a bit of a dent there, I'm going to bring that up a bit. So we need some ultramarine. Ah, yellow ochre. And I'm going to push that yellow ochre in here. Just to get that embankment a little bit more level than that big ding it had earlier. Still that line from my drawing underneath, not a crisis. Brush again and just work this into a flatter area here. Just darken that edge where the river meets the bank. Up a bit. And then I think I want to just put something on the corner here. Maybe a bush of some kind. So, the dark green again. Blue and yellow ochre. Mossy type stuff here. Just right down to the river. grassy type moss or whatever. I think I need to let this dry a bit. I need to consider what I want to do. See if I can do a rock. Some grass, that is what's bugging me here. Add a touch of grass.